John Giorno. He is the best of William Burroughs, the fourth CD box set from Giorno Poetry Systems, will be released by Mercury Malcolm Mighty Records at the end of January. Please welcome John Giorno.
Thank you. I'm going to read some excerpts from a piece that I'm working on now that's called The Death of William Burroughs. William died on August 2nd, 1997, Saturday at 6:30 in the afternoon from complications from a massive heart attack he had had the day before. I was with William Burroughs when he died, and it was one of the best times I ever had with him. Don't touch the body, I said to James right after William stopped breathing. Dying is a complicated process, and often the psychic winds, subtle winds, continue flowing in the channel long after the breathing stops. The hospital left William untouched for over 6 hours until one Sunday morning when the funeral home came to fetch the body. William's consciousness left his body when they moved him. During Tibetan Nyingma Buddhist meditation practices, I absorbed William's consciousness into my heart. It seemed like a bright white light, blinding but muted, empty. A gentle shooting star came in my heart and up the central channel and out the top of my head to a pure field of great clarity and bliss. It was very powerful. William Burroughs resting in great equanimity and the vast open expanse of primordial wisdom mind. I was staying in William's house doing my meditation practices for him, trying to maintain the good conditions and dissolve any obstacle that might be arising for him at that moment in the bargain. It was still a little hard to believe William was dead. Now I really had to do it for him, immediately, with direct certainty and confidence. A feeling of William's consciousness pervaded my consciousness and all phenomena and the walls and furniture. The air in the house glowed with clarity. William, resting in great equanimity and the union of wisdom and emptiness. On Tuesday at about 1 in the afternoon, James Grauerholz came to pick me up to go to the funeral home to see for the first time William's dead body. Nobody had seen it since it was taken away. James and I walked right in, and there was the corpse of William dead in the coffin. William Burroughs, the dead man. Clear, serene power radiating from his mind filled the space. Now, there were things to do with William's dead body. I put the mandala of Kundazoko at his heart center, touching his skin. It's called liberation through touch. But the funeral director, for some reason, had put a t-shirt on the body. So he got a scissor and cut a slit through William's shirt and t-shirt. And I slipped the 3-inch circular photograph of the blue-black Buddha with white consort, Yab-Yu, facing down, touching William's cold, hard skin. I slipped my fingers in the slit a little more and ran my fingertips over the silky, clammy, cold meat. Amazing. Then I tied a protection cord around his neck. It was from a Jetson namesake empowerment of Guru Padmasambhava I had 2 weeks before. I tied it and tucked it in down under his cuff. After going over some details with the funeral home director, James left me to do meditations